sisters of Crocus, purple and gold.
Major, there's a girl in here.
Do you mean Alar?
My name is Mary Lennox. Where has everyone gone? Where's my Aya?
We searched the servants' bungalow as well, sir. It's just one black snake and this girl here.
Why has no one come for me?
I'm afraid there's no one left.
It's a bloody miracle she escaped the cholera, though God knows how. She was drinking the same water they was.
But where are my mother and father?
I'm sorry, miss.
Where shall I take the girl, sir? Our orders are to burn anything that may be contaminated.
To the governor's house for now. I hear there's an uncle somewhere.
Yes, sir. You'll have to leave that picture here, miss.
No, I will not. I'm taking it with me.
It's of your pretty mother, is it?
No, it isn't.
Yes, well, come along then.
Can it be a dream? Surely it does seem like a frightful dream. How can this be true?
Won't her mother come wake her up to play. Won't her father say, here's a rose for you. There's a girl who no one sees. There's a girl who's left alone. There's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known. For the life she's never known.
She's such a sour young thing. Perhaps if Rose spent more time in the nursery, Mary might have learned some of her mother's more pretty ways.
What a nightmare must have been for the girl. Torn up to bed in the middle of the party, and they wake up the next morning with them all dead.
Good evening, Major. I'm Mr. Craven's housekeeper. Is this the girl?
Yes, ma'am. Here's her death certificates, papers, and all. Her father was captain of my regiment. A fine man he was, too. We're all very sorry.
Thank you, Major.
Yes, ma'am. Pleasant journey to you, ma'am.
Well, now, I suppose you'd like to know something about where you're going.
Would I?
But don't you care about your new home?
It doesn't matter whether I care or not.
Now, in all my years, I've never seen a child act so strange, look so old.
High on a hill sits a big old house with something wrong inside. Spirits haunt the halls and make no effort now to hide it. Will put their souls to rest and stop their ceaseless sighing? Why do they call out children's names and speak of one who's crying?
Why you're being brought to Misselthwaite, I'll never know. Your uncle isn't going to trouble himself about you, that's sure and certain. He never troubles himself about anyone.
And the master hears the whispers on the stairways dark and still.
He's a hunchback, you see. A sour young man he was. Got no good of all his money and big place till he were married.
To my mother's sister.
Her name was Lily, and she was a sweet, pretty thing. Need to walk the world over to get a blade of grass that she wanted. Nobody thought she'd marry him, but marry him she did. It wasn't for his money, neither. But then, when she died...
How did she die?
Made him worse than ever. He travels most of the time now. It's your uncle's brother, Dr. Craven, makes most of the decisions these days. Of wild land that nothing grows on but heather, gorse, and broom. Nothing lives on but wild ponies and sheep.
But what is that awful howling sound?
That's the wind blowing through the bushes. They call it weathering that sound. Look there, that tiny light far across there. That'll be the gate, it will.
Sachi, the girl's parents are dead. She's traveled 6,000 miles to get here. You are her guardian. The least you can do is be here to greet her.
I can't, Neville. I wouldn't know what to say. I'll be upstairs.
Mary Lennox, this is Dr. Craven, your uncle's brother.
How do you do?
You have to take her to her room. He doesn't want to see her.
Very good, Doctor.
Can it be a dream? Surely it does seem like a frightful dream. No one here she knows. Shadows on the walls, dark and drafty halls. Catch her if she falls, still no fear she shows.
This room and the next are where you live. But you mustn't expect that there'll be people to talk to you. You have to look after yourself. When you're in the house, don't go wandering the halls. Your uncle won't have it.
Won't have it.
Albert, please.
Rose, I really must send you and Mary away until we get this collar under control.
And what shall I do? Wander around the hills alone with our child while she stares at me the whole time?
She's not staring at you, Rose. She just wants to look at you like the rest of us.
Good night, then.
Yes, ma'am.
There's a girl who no one sees. There's a girl who's left alone. There's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known.
Bye. Me mother asked me, lassie, tell me what your lad mun do before he gives his art away and makes a nest and all the rest. I told me, darling mother, there's something he mun do, but I'll say first how he mun look, his eyes they mun be too.
Are you my servant?
Well there, Mary Lennox, me name is Martha, and now thou'rt help will make the bed.
Aren't you going to dress me first?
Can I dress thyself then?
In India, my ayah dressed me.
Well then, it'll do thou good to wait on thyself a bit. 'Tis fair a wonder grand folks' children don't turn out fair fools, being washed and took out to walk like they was puppies.
What is this language you speak?
Well, of course you've not heard any Yorkshire living in India, have ye? Mrs. Medlock said I'd have to be careful, or you wouldn't understand what I was saying. But I didn't know what to expect from you either. When I heard you was coming from Bombay, I thought you'd be a solid brown, I did. But you're not brown at all. More yellow, I'd say. Anyhow, lassie, I didn't know you'd be so easy vexed. I'll help you on with your clothes this time if you like. You just pretend you're back in India and I'm your servant. You just give me that little yellow foot.
I'm quite all right, thank you.
Look there, out the window. It's the moor, it is, like a dull purple sea this morning. Do you like it?
I hate it.
Ah, you wait till spring then, for the moor is fair covered in gorse and heather, and there's such a lot of fresh air. Me brother Dickon goes off and plays in the moor for hours. He's got a pony that's made friends with him, and birds and sheep and such as eats right out of his hand.
These are not my clothes.
I miss your uncle.
These are nicer than mine.
You get these new clothes on then and wrap up warm and run out and play. That will give you a stomach for your porridge.
Miss Medlock said there's nothing out there but a big old park.
Maybe I'll run into our Dickon out there. Maybe he'll give you a ride on his pony. Maybe he'll...
I don't know anything about boys.
If I had a fine white horse, take you for a ride today. But since I have no fine white horse inside, I'll have to stay and empty all the chamber pots and scrub the floors and such. But what's there to do on a fine white horse? It seems to me not much. If I had a wooden boat, I'd take you for a sail today, but since I have no wooden boat inside, I'll have to stay and catch and kill the mice and pluck the chickens for the cook. But what's there to do on a wooden boat but sit up straight and look and worry our boat would start to drift and float us out to sea and land us on an isle of gold. Oh dear, oh dearie me. If I had a chambermaid, I'd take you out to play today. They say out there's a maze where once you enter, there you stay. For certain we'd get lost and they'd come looking for our boat and find us sometime late next week and bring us tea and scones. But what if there's a clan of trolls that camp beneath the tree? Or what if there's a pirate's cable, dear, oh dear, oh dearie me? If I wasn't so afraid, take you out the door today. But talking birds and tales of fairies keep me scared away. And yes, I promised not to tell what help there is, although if in the maze you chance to see a garden guarded by a tree and meet a bird who speaks to thee, then come and tell my fine white horse and me. Oh, now there's Mrs. Medlock's bell, and I've got all this to clean up first. Can you find your way out yourself? It's down the stairs and past the
ballroom. I'll find it.
Mary Lennox! I thought that I might like to have a skipping rope to play with. Mary Lennox! I forgot the rope. Thank you.
girl I saw in the valley, a girl I hardly knew, a girl at work in the garden, grew to gently, oat cakes and cream, sweet plums in a jar.
And every day to my garden, this man who might he be, came bearing baskets of roses for his Archibald?
Who's that?
It's Mary Lennox, sir. Are you my Uncle Archibald?
Yes, I am. Good morning, child.
Are you going to be my father now?
I'm your guardian, though. I am a poor one for any child. I offer you my deepest
sympathy. Is this my Aunt Lily in this picture?
Yes, it is. Where'd you get this?
It was on my dresser in India. Maybe Mother put it there. I don't know.
Your mother and my Lily. Excuse me. Who dressed you, child?
Martha tried to, sir.
Yes, I see.
Lily, you've been dancing with that gloomy Archibald all evening.
He's just shy, Rose. I think Archie has the tenderest heart I've ever known.
Silly Lily, were you so lost in his eyes that you missed the hump on his back?
I do hope you'll enjoy the gardens.
But I want to know what happens to dead people.
Well, quite natural that you should wonder that. Let's see. We bury them. We put their things away. We remember things they said. We talk to them sometimes. In our minds, of course.
Can they hear us?
And then one morning, when we think we're over them at last, we find ourselves in the ballroom, knowing full well we have been there all night. We draw the painful conclusion we have been dancing with them again.
I don't understand.
Nor will you ever. They're not gone, you see. Just dead.
Is my Aunt Lily a ghost now?
Why? Have you heard her?
I heard someone crying in the house last night, but I don't know anything about ghosts. Is my father a ghost now? Does everyone who dies become a ghost?
They're only a ghost if someone alive is still holding on to them.
Maybe what I heard was Mother telling me to be nice so you'll keep me.
The house is haunted, child, day and night. But it is yours to live in as long as I am the master here. I offer you my deepest sympathies on your arrival.
Did my mother have any other family? Skip the ladies to the master's gate. Sip, sip the ladies while the master raid. Tiptoed the chambermaid who stole their pearls. Snip, snip the gardener and cut off their curls.
It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of ways. Any man can spend his days. It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of paths. But the soul can find the way.
For an old man knows how a year it goes, how the cold, hard ground in the spring comes round, how the seeds take hold and the ferns unfold, how an English garden grows.
Skip, skip the ladies to the master's gate, sip, sip the ladies while the master raids.
Come along, love, come fly away, fly along, come along, fly away home.
It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of paths meant to lead a soul astray.
Take a left and then turning left again, how a soul can find the way. For an old man knows,
it's a maze, this garden,
how a year it
goes. It's a maze of ways,
come fly away,
it's
time it knows,
come fly away home.
Skip, skip the ladies, skip the ladies,
come fly away,
fly away home. Skip, skip the ladies to the master's gate. Sip, sip the ladies while the master's aid. Tiptoe the chambermaid who stole their bow. Sip, sip the gardener and cut off their curls. Good morning, Ben.
Back again today, are you? What have you been doing out there?
Just wandering around. I don't have anybody to play with and nothing to do.
Dickens there. Why don't you go play with him? I saw him myself not 5 minutes ago, conjuring with that stick of his.
I haven't met Dickon. I'm not sure he even exists. I think you and Martha just made him up.
Well then, give you this spade if you want to dig a little hole somewhere.
A little hole for what?
You and me are a good bit alike. We're neither of us good looking, and we're both as sour as we look.
I saw that Robin again today.
I'm sure you did. Never was much as like for being meddlesome. He's the real head gardener around here, chirping at me to come see some bush needs pruning.
I know where he lives too. It's a walled garden with a tall hedge all around it, and no door, and that funny tree growing out over the top of it. I think that tree is the same one my Aunt Lily is sitting in this picture. Am I right?
That it is, Missy. That was your Miss Lily's garden.
Her garden? But I want to see it. Can you show me the door?
I'm afraid I can't. You see, when she died, your Uncle Archibald, he locked the door, threw away the key, said no one was ever to go in there again. And now, the ivy's grown up over the door such that I don't even know where it is now.
But aren't you worried the garden is all dead with nobody taking care of it?
Well, of course I am. But if I so much as set foot in there...
Maybe the real reason the robin is chirping at you is he wants you to climb over his garden wall and work on it.
Maybe so. But I can't exactly count on the advice of a bird.
My Uncle Archie said...
Your Uncle Archibald is gone most of the time. And who's to say what might happen if you weren't here to stop it?
Do you believe in spirits?
Old place like this, there's more of them than there are of us.
I heard that crying again in the house last night.
That could very well be a spirit yard. They like a long hallway and a tall ceiling to swoop around in.
In India, once, I saw a spirit pull a big dead snake right up out of a basket and make him dance.
I'm sure you think you've seen just about everything there is to see except the inside of that garden, Missy. And you keep it that way. You hear me?
Good day, Ben.
Winter's on the wing, here's a fine spring morn. Coming clean through the night comes the May, I say. Winter's taking flight, sweeping dark cold air. Out to sea, spring is born, comes the May, I say. And you'll be here to see it. Stand and breathe it all the day. Stop and hear it, spring, I say. And now the sun is climbing high, rising fast on fire, glaring down through the gloom, gone the gray. I say the sun spells the doom of the winter's rain, ice and chill must retire, comes the May, say I, and you'll be here to see it. Stand and breathe it all the day, stoop and feel it, stop and hear it. Spring, I say. Might they be gone, ye howling gales, be off ye frosty morns. All ye solid streams begin to fall. Melt ye waterfalls, part ye frozen winter walls. See, see, now it's starting, and now the mist is lifting high, leaving bright blue air, rolling clear across the moor comes the May. I say the storm will soon be by, leaving blue sky, soon the sun will shine, comes the day, say I, and you'll be here to see it. Stand and breathe it all the day, stoop and feel it, stop and hear it. Spring, I say.
La 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 la.
Hello there, Mary.
Who are you?
I'm Arthur's brother, Dickon. I hope I didn't fright thee.
But what are you doing here?
Well, I did fright thee, I'm sorry.
But why haven't I seen you before?
Well, about to get the move gentle and speak low on wild things as about.
You mean you're here all the time?
Well, if something's sake, I take a look at it, sure I do. And find the ponies that wander off and the eggs that roll out of the nest. Ah, but look here. Me mother sent you a penny's worth of seeds for your garden. There's columbine and poppies by the handful.
I don't have a garden.
But don't you want one? One of your own, I mean. Well, come and take a look at your seeds, why don't you? Well, if you don't want them,
I want to go in that garden, where the robin lives.
I wasn't sure you'd seen him.
Seen him? He's done nothing but chirp at me ever since I got here.
Well, you have to understand. He's making his nest, and he can't afford to have you interfering if you're not friendly.
How do you know that?
Because we were just talking about you. How do you think?
He was talking too, or just you?
Well, but he thinks it's how you're looking for a spot to build your nest yourself, only it looks like the emu nest have to be pretty big.
Have you ever been in there?
Well, it's not mine to go into, Mary. But it might be yours, I can't say. He's been keeping it safe for somebody, that much I know.
He has?
Same way as the ivy grew up behind the door. But maybe the robin is waiting to hear why you want to go in there, exactly. Being as he's got the safest nesting spot in all England, he's wise to be wary.
Can you tell him I'm friendly?
Well, I could. But what if you wanted to tell him something and I wasn't here? Be much quicker if you learned to talk to him yourself.
But what could I say that he would understand?
Well, I wouldn't mention you're an egg-eater, if you know what I mean. But are you interested in flying, perhaps, or bugs?
I'm afraid not.
Well, then just tell him about yourself, and I'll translate to Yorkshire for you to get the way of it.
I...
She...
I'm a girl...
She is a lass, has took a greatly fancy to thee. Dost thou fear?
Thou may not fear.
She took thee on for like to vex thee. Now to the sword.
Now to the sword.
She knows well she mun't fright thee.
Can ever show me?
The better to know her.
Show me the key.
Show her the key. She is a lass and thou'rt right, she needs a spot where she can rest in.
I mun sit where I'll not be so thinking thoughts or feel a guessing.
Now to the
sort.
She fair be watching for the spring.
I'll not be climbing. up, I'll only be calling good morning, and fellow, I'll sing.
Well done, Mary.
Lily, what are you looking for?
Wait till you see it. It's the most beautiful garden I ever... But I can't find it because the door's so covered over with ivy. Oh, wait, maybe it's on this other side.
I'll only walk around as like to see it for myself. If thou canst allow me visit, I'll speak lowly to thyself. Thou not be bothered night and day by wenches racing round. I'll but seem a silent dream. Standing on the secret ground, I but smell the growing things, count the roses against the wall. Hear thy babe when first they peck, stretch my hands if they should fall. Or if thou likes, I'll bring thee seeds or worms all in a mound. For if thou would have me for a friend, that would be the first I found. I'm a lass,
a trusty lass,
that took a greatly fancy to the Kenneth. Show me,
farewell, dost I know her.
Show me the key,
show her me the key. Well, then I'm off then.
But where are you going?
Well, I can't say, but I'll see you tomorrow, sure enough. And if you need me before then, now that you and the Robin is talking, he always knows where I am.
But can't you help me look for the key?
Well, that's even Mary Abati can't find the thing in the crowd.
All right then, bye.
And you'll be here to see it, stand and breathe it all the day. Stoop and feel it, stop and hear it. Spring, I say.
Got time to play hide and seek now. Mrs. Medlock wants us in the house right now. Mary!
Skip, skip the ladies to the master's gate. Sip, sip the ladies while the master raid. Tiptoe the chambermaid, stole the post. Snip, snip the gardener and cut off their curls.
This rain never stop.
Archie, I'm so pleased. I finally located a suitable school for our Mary.
A school?
She needs the company of other children, particularly after a tragedy such as this.
But she's practically just arrived. Does she want to leave?
This is no house for a child. What will she have to do here, wander the halls?
As I do, you mean? What a wretched house it is. Father should have given Mithelswade to you, Neville, not me.
You are the elder brother, Archie. That would never have occurred to him. But if you continue to feel you cannot stay here, then leave. You were happy once before in Paris,
and you're still a young man. There's no reason to
I can't leave, Neville.
But what good does it do to sit by the boy's bed, night after night, hoping for a miracle?
They've been known to happen.
When Lily died, I gave up my practice to care
you
for them.
You have been completely faithful, Neville. I'm deeply grateful.
But I did not give up that responsibility to you, Archie. I cannot allow you to waste your life waiting for the inevitable end. I cannot.
I'm not wasting my life, Neville. This is my life now.
Beg pardon, sir. You sent for young Mary?
Yes. Come in. Perhaps we can manage to have a moment before the storm carries us away. Take a chair.
Thank you, sir.
Are you well? Do they take good care of you?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry it's been so long since we last spoke. It's just, I keep forgetting about you. I intended to find you a school to go to, or...
Oh, no, please don't send me away.
No, of course not. But perhaps you would enjoy a governess, considering you've had a chance to look around and realize there's nothing for you to do. What do you say to that?
Please don't make me have a governess, sir. There's everything for me to do here. There's so many gardens to walk around, so much to learn about them. Martha gave me a skipping rope, and Vicky gave me some seeds, and...
And here's a rose for you, Mary. Happy birthday,
yes,
darling.
All right, then. Play outside if you like, but is there anything you need? Would you like some toys or books or dolls, perhaps?
Might I?
Speak up, child.
Might I have a bit of earth, sir?
A bit of earth?
To plant seeds in, yes, sir. A garden.
Do you care about gardens so much, then?
I didn't know about them in India. I was always ill and tired, and it was too hot. I sometimes played at making little flower beds, sticking things in the sand, but here I might have a real garden if you would allow it.
And you're sure there's nothing else?
No, sir.
All right, then. You may have your earth. Take as much earth as you want.
Thank you very much, sir.
You may leave, child.
It's much worse being back this time. The dreams are much more vivid, and I hear things. Pause.
It's the girl, Archie.
Do you mean Mary? But I barely see her.
It's because you can't see her, Archie. Because she reminds you of Lily.
You can't be serious.
I can see the resemblance myself. Although, Lily's hair was more... You were very kind to take the girl in, Archie, but in your state, it's simply too much. If you continue to allow the girl to stay here, to grow up here, I have no doubt that, to say the very least, your dreams will get even worse.
But you can see the girl is lonely, Neville. Perhaps I should be having more conversations with her.
I don't think that is wise, Archie.
A bit of earth.
Until you're ready to send her to
she
a school.
Wants a little
is my professional
bit
advice
of earth,
to continue to obey your natural instinct
seeds.
And avoid her.
The seeds will grow.
Archie!
The flowers bloom, but is their bounty what she needs?
You see the charm these leases.
Can she chance to love a little bit of earth she not know? The earth is old and doesn't care if one small girl wants things to grow. She needs a friend. She needs a father, brother, sister, mother's arms. She needs to laugh. She needs to dance and learn to work her girlish charms. She needs a home. The only thing she really needs I cannot give. And she asks.
Kitty. She should have a pony gallop across the moor. She should have a doll's house with 100 rooms per floor. Why can't she ask for a treasure? Something that money can buy that won't die when I'd give her the world. She asks instead for something. A bit of earth, she wants a little bit of earth, she'll plant some seeds. Seeds will grow, the flowers bloom, their beauty just the thing she needs. She'll grow to love the tender roses, the leaves fair, the iris tall. And then in fall, her bit of earth will freeze and kill them.
This house seemed to be, and I, her bravest knight, became my lady fair. Was she?
She has her eyes, she has my lily's hazel eyes, whose eyes had loved my brother, never me. Those eyes that never saw me, never knew I longed to hold her.
close to live at last in Lily's eyes. Imagine me a lover, longed for the day she'd turn and see me standing there. Would God had let her stay. She has my Lily's hazel eyes.
Those eyes that saw me happy long ago.
How can I now forget that once I died dead to be in love, alive and whole in Lily's eyes, in Lily's eyes.
Someone is crying, just now I heard them. Someone in this house is crying, why won't they tell me? I know they're lying, someone here is lost or mad. I must try to find them, beg them stop so I can sleep. I am Mary Lennox. Archibald Craven is my uncle. Who are you?
How do I know you're not a ghost?
I'll pinch you if you like. That will show you how real I am. Who are you?
I'm Colin. Mr. Craven is my father. I see no one and no one sees me, including my father. I'm going to die.
How do you know?
Because I hear everyone whispering about it. If I live, I'll be a hunchback, but I shan't live.
Well, I've seen lots of dead people, and you don't look like any of them.
Dead people? Where did you come from?
From India. My parents died there of the cholera, but I don't know what happened to them after that. Perhaps they burned them. I don't know.
My mother died when I was born. That's why my father hates me.
He hates that garden, too.
What garden?
Just a garden your mother liked. Have you always been in this bed?
Well, sometimes I'm taking places to the seaside, but I won't stay long because people often stare at me. And one time this grand doctor came from London and told me to take off this iron drink Dr. Craven made me wear and to keep me in fresh air. But I hate fresh air, I won't be taken out.
If you don't like people to see you, do you want me to leave?
Yes. But I want you to come back first thing tomorrow morning and tell me all about India. In the books my father sent me, I read that elephants can swim. Have you ever seen them swim? They seem altogether too large to be swimmers, unless they use their ears to-
I can't come talk to you in the morning. I have to go outside and look for something with Dickon.
Who's Dickon?
He's Martha's brother. He's my friend.
If you go outside with that Dickon instead of coming here to talk to me, I'll send him away.
You can't send Dickon away.
I can do whatever I want. If I were to live, this entire place would belong to me someday. They all know that.
You little Raja, if you send Dickon away, I'll never come into this room again.
I'll make you. They'll drag you in here.
I won't even look at you. I'll stare at the floor.
You're selfish thing.
You're more selfish than I am. You're the most selfish boy I've ever seen.
I'm selfish because I'm dying.
You just say that to make people feel sorry for you. If you were a nice boy, it might be true. But you're too nasty to die.
No, please don't go. It's just that the storm scares me and afraid if I fall asleep, I might not wake up.
then close your eyes and I will do what my Aya used to do in India. I will pat your hand and stroke it and sing something quite low.
And I have such terrible dreams.
I have bad dreams too. Last night I dreamed about my father, only he had this lump on his back, like your father. Then when he turned around, he was your father.
Some nights I dream that a round-shouldered man comes in my room on a beam of moonlight. He never says what he wants, just sits with a book in his hands. And then I dream that the round-shouldered man takes me off on a ride through the moors by moonlight. He never says where we'll go. We just ride across the hills till dawn. And some nights I'm going to ask him, is the night sky black or blue? I know the answer's in his book of all that's good and true.
It's no wonder you have such bad dreams. The shadows in this room are so strange.
Once I dreamed that the round-shouldered man took my hand and we walked to a secret garden. I heard my father speak my name as he sat in a crook of a broken tree. And some night I'm going to ask him how the old moon turns to new. I know the answer's in of all that's good and true. I know the answer's in his book of all that's good and true.
Colin, I just realized, we're cousins.
We're cousins?
Mary Lennox.
I've been afraid of something like this. He must have a crest. If she's
but
been...
I've never seen him before.
How can I hope to exist with him if my orders are not followed?
I told her to stay in a room, but she refuses to obey.
I only wanted him to stop crying.
What is that infernal wailing?
It's a servant's rose.
Now you listen to me, Mary Lennox.
The cholera, it's quite bad.
10,000 dead at last count.
Do you see what you've done?
I should have sent you and Mary away while there was still time.
You are never to see Colin again.
But why?
It's exactly what they deserve, letting their sewage run in the streets.
The one rule you were given here, you have violated.
But how are we to get around with all the dead and friggin' flames?
The servants, darling, there are millions of them.
Do you wish to speak to her, doctor?
No. May I ask for a glass of water?
But why didn't you tell me he was here?
I'm feeling quite warm, Abbott.
Because I was ordered not to, and I obey my orders because I wish to keep my place here, and I advise you to do the same.
Mary, where's Mary?
Do you understand?
Someone find her, there's a child.
See, my rose has died. Dig it up and out you go.
Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow?
It's a maze, it's gone.
It's a maze of ways.
Out something wrong inside it.
It's a maze, this garden is a maze of ways.
Something wrong inside it.
It's a maze to lead a soul astray. It's a maze, this garden is a maze of ways.
It's a maze, this garden is a maze of ways. Meant to lead a soul astray.
Crying.
Mistress Mary, quite contrary. How does your garden grow? How did Mary fall? Snap's God is lost in a
Mary! Mary!
high on a hill sits a big old house with something wrong inside it. Spirits haunt the halls and make no effort now to hide it. And the master hears the whispers on the stairways dark and still. And the spirits speak of secrets in the house upon the hill.
Archie, you must tell me what you're to do with Mary. She goes where she wants to go, and she does what she wants to do. I cannot hope to succeed with Colin's treatment if she's allowed to sneak into his room and disturb him. You must send her away before she undoes everything we've tried to do.
Can't send her away, Neville. She has no one on earth but me. Can't you keep her outside? She likes the gardens, I believe.
What are you doing, Archie?
I'm going away. You have things well in hand here.
Well in hand? Haven't you heard anything I've just said?
And last night, I dreamed I walked through the maze and saw Lily and Mary standing there. Mary, right there in Lily's garden. I turned away. I couldn't watch. I was afraid.
Why won't he say what he wants? Why must he speak in dreams? Why can't he see what he wants to disappear? Seems he should send this haunted girl far away. Leave the house and lands to me.
I watched them walk around the garden. She stood tall, grown strong and bold. Then they turned and asked my pardon. I could not speak my heart, grown cold.
Why can't he see what he wants? He wants the past undone. Why can he know once his losing battles won? To have never loved, never known how complete a loss can be. She could disappear, he'd start again and live like other men. He could be happy then. If she disappear, he could be free, cut off from pain and loss, a bit like me.
You can't marry this Archibald. He's a gloomy, miserable cripple who hides himself away in that horrible house. You've said it yourself. He can't believe you love him, and neither can I.
No one is asking for your approval.
Lily, if you don't care what happens to you, think about your children. Do you want your children to be crippled as well?
I will marry him.
I can arrange what he wants.
Don't do this.
He's left it all to me.
Don't wed him.
Now he can have what he wants.
Don't bed him.
Unfettered he will
don't
be. Set him free to wander through the world. Let him go his lonely way.
And then I long to join them, know the peace they feel, their journey done. Then I will once more without them.
Gone long. Perhaps just till autumn.
And Mary?
I'll write her a note from Paris.
You wouldn't be sending her away, Archie. Only giving her the education she deserves. I'm quite sure that Albert and Rose wouldn't want to see their child to grow up just wandering around.
Yes. Well. Perhaps we should look into a few schools then. Someplace she could learn to sing would be pleasant. I'll leave it all in your hands, Neville. I'll go looking on Colin and...
Just be sure you don't wake him.
In 10 years, have I ever awakened the boy?
I'll gather the staff so you can say goodbye.
Oh, for God's sake, Neville. Just let me slip away. I'm sorry. Tell them whatever you always tell them.
And a man can dream of a simple life, husband, child, and wife, love and faith all round.
The man must wake, stand and greet the day, see what comes his way, feet upon the ground.
Last night, the hideous dragon had carried the maid to his cave by moonlight. He gnashed his teeth, he breathed his fire, the heath quaked, and we trembled in fear. I said, someone must save the sweet raven-haired maiden, though surely the cost will be steep. So we lads all drew lots, our insides tied in knots, and I won, and the rest went to sleep. So I picked up my staff, and I followed the trail of his smoke to the mouth of the cave. And I bid him come out, yea, forsooth I did shout, ye fool dragon, be gone, or behave. And then under my breath, I uttered a charm said to make the worst fiend become kind. Knaves and knights of dire plights now diminished his sights, and it worked, and the dragon went blind. And he charged off the cliff howling mad, and he died, and the maiden accepted my ring. And then you came along, and were brave, bold, and strong, and in thanks every night now I sing. Race you to the top of the morning, come sit on my shoulders and ride. Run and hide, I'll come and find you, climb hills to remind you I love you, my boy, at my side. Another found dragon's appeared. I must leave you, he's scorching our land with his breath. From his lair this one taunts me, he dares me, he haunts me once again. We must fight to the death. Would to God I could stay and instead slay your dragon, this beast who sits hunched on your back. Would God I could take him away from your bed, or cut off or tear off his terrible head, or breathe out my fire on him till he was dead, or beg him to spare you and take me instead. As it is, I must leave you in care of my brother, the wizard, who lives on the hill, who has promised his art will soon pierce through the heart of this dragon that's keeping you ill. And I know that your mother, God bless her, would want you to do as he says and grow strong. And you know that as soon as I can, I'll return. So be brave, son, and know that I long to race you to the top of the morning. Come sit on my shoulders and ride. Run and hide, I'll come and find you. Climb hills to remind you I love you. I love you. My boy at my side.
Come along, love, come fly away, fly along, come along, fly away home. Come along, love, you've come a long way, you've flown all the day, come fly away home.
It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of paths meant to lead a man astray. Take a left and then turning left again, how a soul may find the way.
Ayup, hello there, Mary.
Ayup, hello there.
Why are you in such a bad temper, Mary? Are you wary of looking for the key?
No, I found the key.
You did? So I see. You're wary of looking for the door?
I'm not wary, Dickon. I found the door, too. The garden is dead.
No.
It is. It's all dead.
Well, a lot of things will look dead. It's just biding their time. Now, you tell me exactly what you saw.
It's cold and gray. The trees are gray, the earth is gray, and there's this clingy kind of haze over everything.
Like a body were in a dream.
It's the most forgotten place I've ever seen, with loose gray branches looped all around the trees like ropes or snakes, and dead roots and leaves all tangled up on the ground, so still and cold.
But did you have a real look at anything? Did you just scrape away a bit of the bark and have a real look at anything? Maybe the strongest seeds fair thrive on being neglected if the soil is rich enough. They'll run wild and spread until they're a wonder.
You mean it might be alive? But how can we tell?
Oh, I could tell if a thing is wick.
Wick? I've heard Ben say wick.
When a thing is wick, it has a life about it. Maybe not a life like you and me. But somewhere there's a single streak of green inside it. Now come and let me show you what I mean. When a thing is wick, it has a light around it. Maybe not a light that you can see. But hiding down below, a spark's asleep inside it, just waiting for the right time to be seen. You clear away the dead parts so the tender buds can form. Loosen up the earth and let the roots get warm. Let the roots get warm. And the thing is wick, it has a way of knowing. When it's safe to grow again, you will see. When the sun and water sweet enough to feed it, it will climb up through the earth a pale new green. You clear away the dead pots so the tender buds can form. Loosen up the earth and let the roots get warm. Let the roots get warm. Come a mild day, come a warm rain, come a snowdrop a coming up. Come a lily, come a lilac, come to call, calling all of us to come and see.
When a thing is wick and someone cares about it and comes to work each day like you and me, will it grow?
It will.
Then have no doubt about it, we'll have the grandest garden ever seen. Oh, Dickon, I want it all to be Wick. Will you come and look at it with me?
Well, I'll come every day, rain or shine, if you want me to. All that garden needs is for us to come and wake it up.
But Dickon, what if we save the garden and Uncle Archie takes it back? Oh, Colin wants it.
Aye, what a miracle that would be. Get the poor crippled boy out to see his mother's garden.
You give a living thing a little chance to grow. That's how you will know if she is wicked, she'll grow. So grow to greet the morning, free from ground below. When a thing is wicked, has a will to grow and grow.
I promise there's a single streak of green below, and all through the darkest nighttime, it's waiting for the right time. When a thing is wicked, it will grow.
Smoke to the mouth of the cave, and he bid him come out, yea, forsooth he did shout, ye fool dragon, be gone or behave.
Direct orders.
What can it happen? He likes Mary. Let her ever go at it.
No, Martha.
Colin Craven, you stop that screaming!
It's right from me!
I hate you! Everybody hates you! You will scream yourself to death in a minute, and I wish you would!
Get out of my house!
I won't. You stop.
I can't stop! I feel a lump on my back! I'm going to die!
There's nothing the matter with your horrid back!
I'm gonna have a lump on my back like my father and die!
Martha, show me his back.
Show her the lamp! Now feel it. There.
Where?
Right there.
No, there is not a single lump there, except backbone lumps, and those are supposed to be there.
It's...
See? I have them too.
It's not there?
No, it's not.
It's not there.
You were just mad at me for not coming back when I said I would, weren't you?
Maybe.
You were, and you know it.
We'll leave you two alone, I think.
This is nice.
I'm sorry I said all those things about sending Dickon away. Just I got so angry when you wanted to be with him instead of me, and he didn't come back like you said you would.
I was always coming back, Colin. I'm just as lonely as you are. I was just late, that's all. It took me longer than I thought because...
Because of what?
If I tell you, do you promise not to tell?
I never had a secret before, except I wasn't going to grow up.
I found your mother's garden.
Do you mean a secrets garden? I've dreamed of a secret garden.
It's been locked up out there, just like you've been locked up in here for 10 years. Only I found the key, and the other night after Dr. Craven and Miss Medlock found us in here together, I ran out into the storm and found the door. And now Dickon and I are working on it every day, and you can come too, and...
What does it look like?
Well, right now, there's this tangle of vines all over everything because nobody's been taking care of it. But Dickens says if we cut away all the dead wood, there'll be fountains of roses by summer.
I never want to see anything like I wanted to see that garden.
You must see it. But they must never know where we're going, or Ben says Dr. Craven will send me away.
Mary, no!
Maybe Martha can take you outside in your wheelchair, and Dickon can push you through the maze and into the garden.
I can't go outside, Mary. I'll take a chill if I go. It'll get even worse.
No, you won't. You'll feel better.
I can't, Mary. I'm afraid. It's just I've been in this bed for so long, I don't want to die.
Just one black snake in this girl here.
I'm afraid no one left.
I'd love to see the garden, really I would, but I can't.
All right, then. We'll just wait until you're ready to see it, and whenever that is, you tell me, and I'll get Martha to...
You must come back tomorrow morning after you're through working and tell me all you've done.
I'd like that.
Good night, then.
Good night.
Be doing this. I'm like to be sent back to the scullery for this, Dickon. And I don't like the scullery. I don't know anyone who does.
I'll only be missing out this hour.
But if it's so dark, I can't even see where I'm going. How am I to hope to see what it is once I get there?
Perhaps it's only something meant to hear.
But all I can hear is me own self talking.
Well, then perhaps you best be still.
Dickon, is that you?
Hi, it is, Mary. And Martha, too.
Martha, are you surprised to see me outside in the middle of the night?
my dear lad, that I am Master Colin. But just now you look so much like your mother it made me heart jump.
Martha, come look. It's my mother's garden. It is.
It's a secret garden, and we're the only ones in the world that want it to be alive.
Aye, Colin, we'll have you walking and digging same as other folk before long.
How can I? My legs are so weak, I'm afraid to.
There's a charm in this garden, Colin. And the longer you stay in it, the stronger you'll be.
What kind of charm?
I do, Master Colin, in spirits and the big good thing by whatever name you call it.
Now I know where I heard it. I even know what it means. Go on, then.
Come, spirit. Come, charm. Come, days that are warm. Come, magical spell. Come, help him get well.
Come, spirit. Come, charm. Come, days that are warm. Come, magical spell. Come, help him get well.
Come, spirit, come, charm. Come, days that are warm. Come, magical spell. Come, help him get well.
Oh, Jadu.
old Holland, it worked.
I think the spell is working in the house too. Two nights ago, when it was bright moonlight, I felt something filling the room, making everything so splendid. And I pulled the trigger of my mother's picture. And there she is, her eyes looking right down at me, making me so proud, so strong, so tall. I shall live forever and ever. I shall find out thousands of things. What do you think to something, to anything that will listen? I'm well.
Mary, child, you see what you've done? Oh, Master Colin.
Who is that man? Go away.
Colin, it's Ben Weatherstaff. Who tends the gardens?
Weatherstaff, do you know who I am?
You're young Master Colin, the poor cripple. Lord knows how you got out here, though.
I'm not crippled.
Well then, what have you been doing? Why did not let folks think you were a cripple? And half-witted.
Half-witted? Come down here. I want to talk to you. Don't you dare say a word about this.
I'm your servant, young master, as long as I live.
Did you know my mother?
That I did. I was the right hand around the gardens. Even now, I'm only kept on because she liked me. She said to me once, Ben, if I'm ever ill or if I go away, you must take care of my roses. When she did go away, orders was no one was to come in here. But I come anyway, till my back stopped me, about 2 years ago.
I want to know how she died.
She was sitting right there on that brunch when it broke, and that started her laboring with you, only the fall hurt her back. Still, she clung to life till you were born, then put you in your father's arms and died.
Is that why he hates me?
I'm sure he doesn't hate you, lad.
He doesn't hate you. He doesn't even know you. Wait till he finds out you can stand.
I don't want him to know. I don't want anything said to him so I can walk. Do you promise?
It's getting to be a full-time job, keeping track of all the secrets around here.
Mary, take my hand. Martha, Dickon, you too, Ben. Do you swear by the charm of this garden that none of you mention this to my father until I'm completely well?
I promise. Culinary word.
Good then.
So what do you want to see first?
I want to see the roses. Show me where the roses will be.
A bit of earth, a drop of dew, a single stem begins to pushed away, the flowers bloom before our eyes. For in the earth, the charms at work, the word is past, the days are worn. Unfold and grow, the winter's past, we're free from harm. A bit of earth.
Well, Mrs. Midlock, what a fine morning this has turned out to be.
Yes, Doctor.
I trust this headmistress will be quite impressed riding across the moor such a day. Perhaps she might join me for tea. I dare say she might relish a bit of a civilized conversation, living as she does in the company of spinsters and orphan girls.
I'm sure she'd be quite flattered by your attention, sir.
Beg pardon, Doctor. It's Mrs. Winthorpe, sir.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Come in. Do come in, please.
Good day, Doctor.
This is our housekeeper, Mrs. Medlock.
How do you do?
I trust you had a pleasant journey.
Actually not. I've always found scenery by itself to be quite tiresome.
Oh. Well, you'll be relieved to find we have contrived to keep all the scenery outdoors. Won't you sit down? Completed all the forms you sent us. And I think you'll see that my brother has included a contribution to the school's building fund. You didn't request it, of course, but as I told my brother, I'm sure you're in the planning stages of something or other. Mrs. Miller, will you see what's keeping our Mary?
I'm right here, sir.
Quite right. Here's our girl. Mary Lennox, this is Mrs. Winthrop of the Aberdeen School for Girls.
Good morning, Mary.
I don't want to go to a school.
Oh, but you do. A useless child never knows her worth. That's what we say.
My Uncle Archibald
said... Perhaps we would tell Mary a little about the school. She would see there is no reason to be.
Certainly. And let me just say, you are not on trial here. The Board of Trustees has accepted your application.
Oh. Well, that is good news indeed.
I won't go. You can't make me.
Mary Lennox!
That's okay, Doctor. This is exactly the type of behavior we are best equipped to handle.
My Uncle Archibald is the only one who says where I'm going to go, and he said I don't have to go to any stupid school.
She's just frightened, I'm sure. Children are quite often depressed, especially after a tragedy such as she has suffered.
Of course, Doctor. Perhaps she'll enjoy seeing some photographs of the girls at their work. I've brought fine samples of lace. For...
I hate you! You're a horrible, ugly pig!
That's quite enough, young lady.
Your school is a filthy rat hole full of brats and dirty beds, and all anybody really does there is scrub floors. I hope you get hit by a lorry on your way home, and your ugly head rolls off in a ditch and gets eaten by maggots. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you! And if I'm sent off with you, I'm going to bite your arm, and you're going to die! Get out of here! Go away, go away, go away!
Well, we've had one or two cases of this severity.
Mary Lennox!
Ah! Ah! I hate you! Ah! Ah! Leave! Ah! Ah! Marge Jowell! Barney Jowell! Choro Muche! Dumbari Shiatano! Marjo!
Doctor, what you have here is a medical problem.
Speak with Mary alone, Medlock. Get up.
Giorno Muce, I'm going outside.
You're going wherever I send you, young lady. Right this moment, it's into that chair.
Uncle Archibald said I didn't have to go to a school.
Oh, for God's sake. He doesn't care about you. All he wants is never to see you again. Why do you think he left you without even saying goodbye?
Maybe he was in a hurry.
You drove him away. You remind him of his wife.
I look like my Aunt Lily.
Now it is my task to find a suitable place for you to go so that my brother can return. The next school I contact will send no representative. Your bags will be packed and you will leave Saturday week.
But I can't leave now. Colin needs me.
The last thing that boy needs is you. Another month of trying to keep up with you, I'll have to put him in hospital. Or worse.
No, you won't. He's much better.
You have no idea how ill he is. When Colin was born, the midwife didn't expect him to last a week. But I have kept the boy alive for 10 years. Only now, thanks to you, he's in grave danger of relapse.
But you haven't seen how...
Do you want him in hospital? Do you want him to die?
To die?
Yes, to die. If you push Colin in this stage in his recovery... If you push him to take his first step too soon before his heart is strong enough, Colin will not survive it. Do you understand, Mary? Colin's very life is in your hands. One moment he would be chatting away, the next he would sink to the ground and die.
And die?
Yes. You have choices in your life, but Colin does not. I will not see the boy in hospital for the rest of his life, or dead before his life even begins. You must go. And go you will. Now that is all I have to say to you. Why are you standing here? Are you quite amused to learn of your new power?
I didn't do anything. You locked him in his room.
You may go.
You don't want Colin to get well at all. You want him to die so you can have this house.
You leave
Saturday week! There's nothing here that I want. How dare she make this claim? Isn't it clear what I want? To serve has been my aim. Still, I have to wonder who I'd be if it all belonged to me. If they'd all disappear, I'd start again. I could be happy then. I'd live like other men. If they'd all disappear, I could be free. Cut off from pain and loss. At last I'd be.
It weren't you, child. Your uncle lied to you. I know he did. Didn't he tell you could have a garden? Didn't he send you clothes and bring you books? Well, didn't he?
But Colin's going to die, and it's all my fault.
Then what have you done for Colin except get him going outside every day and get him eating his food and get him believing he can get strong again? I think you were just what Colin needed.
But you're not a doctor, Martha. Will you tell him I'm sorry? I mean, after I'm gone. Will you tell him that I didn't mean to hurt him? That I didn't want to leave?
I think you better tell him that yourself.
But how can I? He'll get mad and start acting all high and mighty, and then Dr. Craven might send him away too.
You're talking like you're already gone, Mary.
I am gone, Martha. I wish I were a ghost.
No ghost could do what you've done in this house, Mary. What you've got to do is finish what you have begun. I don't know just how, but it's not over till you've won. When you see a storm is coming, see the lightning part the skies. It's too late to run, there's terror in your eyes. What you do then is remember this old thing you heard me say. It's a storm. At your door, there's no place to hide. You're frozen to the floor. What you do then is you force yourself to wake up and you say, it's a stream, not me, that's bound to go away. Hold on, the night will soon be by. Hold on and think of something. Child, hold on, there's angels on their way. Hold on and hear them say, child, oh child. And it doesn't even matter if the danger and the doom come from up above or down below, or just comes flying at you from across the room. When you see a man who's raging and he's jealous and he fears that you've walked through,
I should do.
I think you should find a pen and paper and write your uncle in Paris and tell him to come home. I think you should let Colin's father say whether he likes him standing or not.
But why would he listen to me? And what if the letter didn't get to him in time?
I'm sure your uncle will send for you as soon as he sees what you've done for the boy.
Now here's a pen and here's some paper. You do not write, I hope, because I won't be much help to you in that apartment.
A little.
That's all right. You don't have much to say, do you?
G-E-A-R-Uncle Archie. How are you? I'm fine. Everybody else is too. Please come home.
I have no home.
Martha says that you're in Paris. Is that very far away? Do they have nice girls and boys there?
I can't get far enough away from it.
Please come home.
Now just sign it.
Should I say that Colin's well now?
Streets of Paris like a maze.
Should I say that Dr. Craven?
Endless night, nameless day.
Think that what you have is good. Let's get it posted on its way. He'll rush home and you could tell him all the rest you have to say.
Oh, kind sir. Uncle Archie, how I wish that you could see.
When you come into the garden, please come home.
Can't forgive.
Yours truly.
Well, maybe.
Sincerely.
Well, how about?
Now I see you in the window of a carriage, then a train. Still my mind will not accept that in your grave you must remain. Now I hear your voice and turn and see a stranger's form and face. Must I wander on tormented place to place, to place, to place? Where can I go that you won't find me? Why can't I find a place to hide? Why did you have to chase me, haunt me? Every step you're there beside me. Where in the world, tell me where in the world can I live without your love? Where on the earth, tell me where on the earth should I stay now that you are gone? Why did I have to meet you, love you? Why can't I rid you from my mind? Why did you have to want me? Won't you let me put my life behind me? How in the world, tell me, how in the world can I live without your love? Why on the earth, tell me, why on the earth should I stay now that you are gone?
Lily? Is that you?
How could I know I would have to leave you? How could I know I would hurt you so?
You were coming.
I didn't know myself, Neville.
I'll take that back, thank you.
Fine, then you're going to push me in the chair.
Well, I'm lots faster than you, you'll see.
No, you're not.
What on earth is all that noise?
Here we go.
Colin Craven, not so fast.
Mary Lennox.
Father! Look at me, I'm well.
Oh, Colin. Can you ever forgive me?
It was the garden that did it, Father. Mary and Dickie and some kind of chairman came out of the ground and...
Neville, were you hoping to surprise me with this news?
I had no idea they were looking better. I had no idea.
We didn't want you to know. We thought you wouldn't let us come to the garden if you knew.
But how did you...
Dickie carried me down the stairs until...
But what did you eat? You didn't touch any of the food we sent up for weeks.
Martha sent us food. We ate in the garden. We ate enough for 10 children.
You did you?
Oat cakes and roasted eggs and fresh milk and...
It was all terribly confusing. After all these years, just...
It was confusing, Neville. Why don't you take my flat in Paris and stay as long as you like? And then, when you return, perhaps you'll allow me to help you reestablish your practice somewhere in town, if you like, so you can resume your own life. Free of the enormous burden you have carried on our behalf.
Thank you, Archie.
And will you be staying home with us?
Oh, Colin, look at you.
It was Ben that kept the garden alive, Father, so you could get here.
I know it was against your orders, sir, but...
As I remember, it was Lily who ordered you to take care of the garden, Ben. Well done.
Thank you, sir.
And it was Dickon who...
Yes, I can imagine. Dickon, if there was ever anything
we... What is to become of our Mary?
Clusters of crocus.
Why, Mary.
Here's your key, if you want it back, sir. You didn't bury it after all. I'd have never found it if you...
I'd nearly forgotten you and all this.
It's hard to remember everybody, sir.
No, it isn't. Three isn't very many people at all. I should be able to remember three people quite easily.
And would I be one of them?
Mary Lennox. For as long as you will have us, we are yours, Colin and I. And this is your home. And this, my lovely child, is your garden.
Yeah.